Okay, folks, in this video I'm going to show you how to use the lathe tool. I can't really explain how the lathe tool works. It'd be used for creating a shape and then kind of lofting it around like a mirror of symmetry, like an origin. The best way to do this is just to literally show it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a line, turn on my snaps, and I'm going to make a bowl. So I'm gonna like create half the shape of a bowl, which would be kind of like this, and then come in here and close it. Right click to close that off. I'm just gonna fillet some things. So this is like half of the shape or like the outline of a bowl. And gonna go to the fillet tool, select these, and just ooh, maybe not that. Round that one off slightly. Round that one off a lot. Okay, so I've kind of got this half-looking bowl shape. I'm just gonna weld that. Need to increase threshold, and this vertex needs to be bang in the center. So I'm just gonna fix that on Y, which is cool. So with this, the last thing I need to do is outline the shape. In fact, I'm actually just gonna. Sorry, I'm just going to delete that shape as well. Bear with me, guys. I'm going to outline everything first. I've done this slightly wrong. It's been a long time since I've done it, but I'm just going to hit outline. Like so. Because the bowl needs to have thickness to it. And I'm literally just going to delete this because my bowl is actually going to be, it's not going to have a top to it. And now I just need to connect this up again. Let me just see if I can remember how to do this. I think it's just connect one to the other, okay. And then what I'm going to do is, I have my shape. I think I can actually delete this line too. I'm going to go to the create panel, go to compound objects, or not. I'm going to go to my line tool again under modifier list. I'm going to choose the lathe modifier. Okay, and click that. And that is totally not a bowl. Hold on. I'm going to delete that. Make sure my pivot is in the center. So effect pivot only, and make sure that on Y it's zeroed out. Because this is my axis or my origin of where this lathe tool is gonna create this shape. Now if you use the lathe tool, you see I've got this kind of bowl shape. You can also change, the degrees it uses. How many segments? So again, think back to your game and how many shapes or how many interpolations you need. I'd probably have to fill it the yeah, you can go back and change this a bit, so maybe I'll fill it these two like so. Make sure that those vertices there are welded. Maybe pull that off a bit like so. Okay, go back to my lathe. Our bowl should be a bit rounder. Might have to just delete that modifier and try again. But yeah, that is a very basic lathe. It takes a shape and it kind of turns it around on itself. It's like oh, it's very hard to explain. But you take a shape and you loft it around, like in a circular motion. I'm gonna show you one more example. Gonna make like a wine glass. So I'm gonna take out my line tool, turn on my snaps this time. Make a very simple kind of wine glass. maybe a cocktail glass. And yeah, I actually stop right there because the glass isn't gonna, you know, this part here is gonna be hollow coming down. I'm going to fillet the lid or the foot of the glass. That's very strange. Fillet tool's not working too well on that part. Make sure that's welded. Might want to fillet this part here. I swear this fillet tool's been very dodgy today. Let me show weld that and fillet this part. So we got this nice kind of gradual glass shape coming out. I know this part looks absolutely pants, but and again, we would leave this, but I just want to double check for myself. Well, first of all, I need to fix the pivot because it lives around the center of it. So just change its pivot to the center on Y, of course, because it is this kind of this axis here. If I put on the lathe modifier, you'll see what happens. It's one-sided essentially, so that's why we go back and we put the outline on it. So we select everything and give it an outline, a very small amount, you know, maybe one. Try it once more. There we go. And I'm just gonna double check the shape. Maybe it might need a cap here, I'm not too sure. At the very top I might want to just select both of these, go into our vertex mode, select both of them and fillet that in like so. Weld this one because there's two vertices. Click weld and make sure everything else is smooth enough looking. Okay. So it's as if you were to kinda, you know, make maybe a million copies like this around the way. This is kinda how the lathe works. If I put the lathe modifier on, you get your kind of glass shape, and because we've outlined it, it hollows it. Let's see, maybe we want to have a couple more segments. What I would heavily advise you doing is going into edit poly mode and then actually killing a lot of these ringed loops. So what do I mean? There's quite a lot here as well. Maybe we'll kill this a wee bit. There isn't actually there's no other option to get rid of, you know, how many there are here. It's just the way it works. So yeah, that's the lathe tool, and what you might want to do is right click and convert it to an editable poly. Grabbing some of these rings like so. Very intensive, and then looping, and then clicking the remove button. See, actually, you get a lot less, and same for the top. But yeah, so yeah, bowls, any kind of like glass objects, you know, there are loads of different examples you can use this. But that's the lathe tool. Okay.